Hi, I'm Ejina James Okorie, the proprietor of James Okorie Technical Institute. Welcome to our channel. Hi, I'm Ejina James Okorie, the moderator of James Okorie Technical Institute. And today, I want us to see how pin relay works, how we can connect pin relay, how we can use pin relay to augment our systems. You know, pin relay is a component which you can use to build up your circuit to make it work in automatic way, because it has coil, and because it has coil, you can use it to automate anything. So this is a pin relay. When you look at this pin relay very well, you see that this is pin relay. Looking at the pin relay very well, you see that this is the coil part and this is the base part. So it's detachable, so you can detach it like this. See that there are two parts now. This is the part that houses the coil, and this is the part that you do your connection. It has terminals that will enable you to do the connection. So now I want us to see how this pin relay works. First, I will first of all show you the terminals and how they behave. So I will start by writing pin relay, like I'm dealing with this pin relay. And this pin relay that I'm dealing with is 11 pin relay. So the coil part is what we are concentrating on now to see what is actually happening. Anytime you want to deal with pin relay, you want to do your connection with pin relay, the first thing you have to check is the coil symbol, because when you look at the diagram, the body of the pin relay, you must see the diagram there. So on the diagram of this pin relay, the coil symbol is there, and the coil symbol that is being used is 2 and 10 terminals, which is the symbol is a rectangular that is cross diagonally, just like this. So this is a rectangle cross diagonally. So this is the coil symbol, and here you see that this terminal and this terminal, this is terminal number 2 and this is terminal number 10 of the pin relay. So looking at the pin relay again, we have other terminals like 1, 3 and 4. 1 is common, 3 is normally open to 1, and 4 is normally closed to 1. So in this case now, you see that first you have to check the common terminals of pin relay. The common terminal of pin relay is the terminal which is common to the normally open and normally closed of its own family. I repeat, the pin relay, they behave like family. We have common, normally open, normally closed. Common, normally open, normally closed. Common, normally open, normally closed. So the common terminal must be common with the normally open and normally closed of this family, just like this. So we have 1. So I will just say this, and I will say this, and I will say this. So this is 1 family. Here we have 1, we have 3, and we have 4. So 1 is common. Why? Because 1 is normally close to 4. 1 is common because 1 is also normally open to 3. Another terminal which we have are the terminal number 8, terminal number 6, 7, and 5. So terminal number 6, 7, and 5. 6 is common. So I will also say this terminal is common to this and also to this. So this terminal now remains 6. Terminal number 6, this is common, normally close to 5, which is this, and normally open to 7, which is this. Another terminal which we have is 11. 11 is normally close to 8 and normally open to 9, which is, this is another one, and this is normally open to this. So in this case, 11 remains common because 11 is normally close to 8, like this, and normally open to 9. So in this case, this is 11 pin relay. When you count the pins, you see that they are 11, and when you look at it very well, you see that this is coil of the pin relay. And when you look at this, you see that this is common terminal and this is normally closed, NC. This is normally open, NO. This is common and this is normally closed, NC, and this is normally open, NO. The same thing happened here. Common, normally closed, NC, normally open, NO. So anytime you are dealing with this kind of pin relay, you know that they behave like one family. After detecting the coil terminal of this pin relay are 2 and 10, which are the coil terminals of the pin relay. Before this pin relay can work automatically, you must supply current to this coil, and this coil now, according to this pin relay that I'm holding, is 220 volts AC. So So you must supply 220 volt AC to this coil before it can function. And where do you find these terminals? Look at it very well. You see that this is the coil terminal. This is the part that houses the coil. But this is where you do your connection. At this point, you see that you will look at it very well. You see where the road 2 and 10. These two antenna are the terminals which you must supply current to before the pin relay can function automatically. And this is the coil of these 2 and 10. So in this case, you look at it very well again. You see 1, 4 and 3 as one family. Like this one is one family. The other one is one family, the other one is one family. So there is no relationship between this and this, and there's no relationship between this and this, or this and this. This one works on its own. So if you are using 1, you must use 4 at the output, or 3 at the output. If you are using 6 as the input, you must use 5 at the output, or 7 at the output. If you are using 11 at the input, you must use 8 and 9. So this is how the terminals of pin relay are. So this is how the terminal of this pin relay is. Now, for example, if you are using this pin relay now to do some connection, let's say that you want to use it to control a contactor. So what you have to do is you do what? You use the you supply current to the coil of this one, then you use this to operate the contactor. Let's say, for example, you want to energize a contactor. So what you do, what you have to do is, first of all, you check contactor terminals. Let's say that this is contactor, and in this contactor now we have terminals like the coil terminals, the L1, L2, L3, T1, T2, T3. So let's say that we have L1, L2, L3, and we have T1, T2, T3, the terminals. So let's say that the contactors are like this. Alright, so now in this case, now let's say that your supply, that you're supplying this contactor comes here, maybe a single phase, the live and the neutral. Alright, and the output goes to the load, which is this. Alright, let's say a bulb, and in this case, this one connects to this, and this one connects to this. So I will call this a lamp. Alright, which is what? Live and neutral. So before this contactor can work, you must energize the coil before you can get output from here to here. Why? Because this is this one, the L1 and T1 are normally open, L2 and T2 are normally open, meaning that L1 is normally open with T1, then L2 is normally open with T2. So in this case, current can never pass in this contactor. So this is a contactor until you energize the coil. So now I will say that the coil is what? A1 and A2. So these are the coil terminals of this contactor, A1 and A2, which require 220 volts in order to energize. So what do you do if you are using pin relay? First of all, what you have to do is what? This is the coil of the pin relay here. Alright, so in this case now, we connect to the coil of the pin relay, which will enable us to energize the contactor. So what we do now is, first of all, we take the coil of the pin relay. I will use the rectangular shape as the coil symbol of the pin relay, like this. And here is terminal number 2 and number 10. I will say here is 2 and here is 10. Terminal number 10. Now, I will take one family of the pin relay, which is 1, which is normally closed to 4 and normally open to 3. So this is 1 and this is 4 and this is 3. Alright, so with this now I can energize the pin relay. So what do I do? First of all, I will connect. Remember, this is single phase. The pin relay coil is single phase, which means that we are using 220 volts in order to energize this coil. This is the coil of this pin relay coil, which requires 220 volts. So in this case now, what I will do is to connect the neutral to one terminal of the distance. You can, don't mind the polarity. Why? Once you are dealing with this single phase AC pin relay, this is AC 220 volts. So what I will do is I connect the neutral first to what? To the neutral, one terminal of the coil, which is this. Alright, and because I want to energize the contactor, I will also connect the A2 of the contactor to this. So the neutral have come to the neutral source, have connected to L2, which I'm using to energize this, but because I needed neutral to energize the coil of this and coil of this, that's why I connected L2 to 10 and from 10 to A2. Alright, so remaining was the live wire in order to complete this for this period to work. So what will I do? What I will do first is to do what? I will take the live wire from here and remaining, meaning remember that this is the source, which is what? 220 volts AC. So in this case now, I will take this L1. This means that these lines are not joining. I will connect to these two. Alright. So because before this pin relay can get output from 3 and 4, one must be connected. You must do what? Supply current to terminal number 1. This is terminal number 1. So what I will do is also from these two, I will supply current to the common, which is terminal number 1. And because I want to energize this contactor in order to make this lamp to glow, in order to make this lamp to shine, what do I do? I use the normally open. Please don't use the normally closed if you want to start something or if you want to on something. If you want to off, that is FOFF, use normally closed. But if you want to on, use normally open. So what I do, I use this normally open. So I connect this normally open to where? To this A1. So in this case now, I have connected the pin relay and the contactor together. So what will happen, before this contactor can energize, this pin relay must first of all do what? Energize and pass normally open in order to energize the coil. Without it, this contactor will not work. So we are using this pin relay now in order to control the contactor, and this is how the diagram of the whole system is, and this is how we are controlling this contactor using this pin relay. So everything about here now remains pin relay. This is pin relay terminals. Terminals, and this is contactor terminals, and these are the terminals of pin relay, how they are. Alright, so this is how we energize the contactor using pin relay, and this is the pin relay we use in this case, and this is the what coil part, and this is how the terminals are. Thank you very much for watching. I still remember my humble self, Engineer James Okorie, the proprietor of James Okorie Technical Institute. Thank you very much. Alright, thank you for watching this powerful video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Just click on the subscribe button you see there for more powerful videos. Thank you very much.